That's really amazing stuff, Grant. Not what we typically see in some of our IT dashboards. You give new meaning to things like flow and syncs and payloads and maybe even logs.
My name's Grant Chase, and I'm the Operational Technology Specialist at the City of Morro Bay, California. At the City of Morro Bay, my role is to manage the control systems from the hardware that supports the motors, sensors, and pumps, all the way to the software that the end user experiences that through. So we monitor the metrics of the water and wastewater treatment facilities for a number of reasons. One is process control, to make sure that we're treating the water or wastewater appropriately. Secondly, the data gives us insight into how efficient we are at actually running the process itself. It allows us to see if there's a problem with a piece of equipment, and we can catch it early because we can tell that the pump is not running as efficiently as it used to, for instance. And it's really easy to see that if you have a nice product for visualization. We started using Grafana in 2019. The old wastewater treatment plant, which was built in 1960, had two metrics that were most important. And my lead worker at the time told me that he used to be able to pull it into a browser, and turned out that that piece of equipment was 20 plus years old. So I quickly realized that it was just a snapshot of a really bad graph. And I told him, give me a couple weeks and I'll figure out how we can record this better. And so I utilized Python and a industrial library for Modbus TCP, pulled that data into InfluxDB, and then I needed a place to see it. And Grafana turned out to be the answer to that. So we had our two metrics, and they were beautifully visualized in Grafana, and that was our first exposure to Grafana. And it really changed our ability to have visualizations, and I started integrating it then to our water system on that same instance. The old wastewater treatment plant was decommissioned, and a new plant was built. The new plant had all of the modern software integrated as part of the build project. And it looked like we were not gonna need Grafana because this platform was gonna provide new things for us. And it quickly became apparent that the engineers were asking for data sets that were available in the database but not visualized anywhere. And they weren't part of the scope of work for that particular contractor building the system. So we needed to quickly pivot. And I already had in my tool bag something that I knew would work well, and that was Grafana. So I spun up Grafana for the new wastewater treatment plant and built out a dashboard for every single process area with every single piece of data. The engineering team was floored that there was a platform that made data that accessible and that easy for them. There's something so gratifying about when an incident happens, the team goes, let's go check Grafana and find out what happened, because they view that as a true resource, as a true tool to help solve problems. Yeah, so our Grafana dashboard, the keystone of it, is the homepage. The homepage is organized in columns with the wastewater flowing from left to right. Each column represents a process area, and below that are navigational buttons that will let you enter deeper into that particular process area. Because there's so many metrics, it would be impossible to display them on a single dashboard and have the operators be able to navigate it efficiently. So this home dashboard is a collection of KPIs for the entire process, as well as a navigational springboard. So all operators start there, and they can get to any other process area from there. Many times that's all they need, is just to see those quick metrics. If you click deeper into a process, you'll see graphs on every single sensor and every single pump or tank level. We even have the laboratory data broken out into their own dashboards and their own folders, as well as videos from our lab's microscope, where we collect data for the treatment facility based on microorganisms that were observed in the basin at any given time. Videos are taken, and then the metadata can be updated. Tags will be updated for each type of microorganism, and that gives us a timestamp of the occurrence of that particular bug, and that really creates a complete or more complete data model for us. We know what the process is, what the samples were like, and what microorganisms were observed at a given period of time.
That was an amazing view of what you're up to at the municipal treatment plant. Thanks so much, and congratulations.
Hey,
your Golden Grot. Cheers.
Thank you, Raj.
I am proud to be recognized by the community, to be recognized by Grafanistas, and to share the kind of endless possibilities that Grafana has built in. If you have a need and you have the right creative approach to it, you can solve it with Grafana, because it's an open enough platform. Again, the big tent, it's all under there, and I am not limited by a software. When, you know, as a developer, I am constantly limited by software. Having one that allows me to continue to innovate and to serve the needs of my team is the biggest aha moment for sure.